Assalamu alaikum, my dear learners. Welcome to my online class. This class is organized by City Government Girls High School, Chattogram. I am Roxana Chaudhary, assistant teacher of this school. My dear learners, hope all of you are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. I am also fine. Today, I am going to teach you from your English grammar and composition book. And it's unit 3, lesson 4 and 5, present continuous tense and present continuous tense indicating a future action. Okay, at first, I'm going to show you some examples. Just like mother is cooking in the kitchen. The cows are grazing in the field. The sheep is floating on the sea. Now, I hope, my dear students, you have understood what we are going to learn, and these are the examples of present continuous tense. Okay, now, at first we will know what is present continuous tense. Okay, now we will know what is present continuous tense. It describes actions which are going now. That means the actions which we are doing or I am doing now. Suppose I am teaching you. And so I am giving the structure, main structure. Subject plus auxiliary verb am, is, are plus ing form of main verb. For example, he is playing chess. Now, my dear student, I am going to show you the full form of present continuous tense. If we, in affirmative sentence, we will do in this way, the structure will be subject plus am, is, are plus verb plus ing plus extension. There is an example here, there is two examples here. He is reading a book. So, we can see that subject. Here is subject is he, and according to the person we have used is, and read is the main verb, and we have added ing, read, and it's a book, it's object. So he is reading a book. In this way we will do, they are waiting for us. Okay, if we want to do it in short form, then we have to do write in this way. He is reading a book. They are waiting for us. Now, we'll see the negative form. In negative form, we have to follow the following structure. That means subject plus am, is, are plus not plus verb plus ing plus extension. So, the example will be, he is not reading a book. Here is subject is he, and is according to the person we have used is. So he is not, we have used not, and reading main verb is read, so we have added ing with the word read, reading a book. And another example is they are not waiting for me. This is the same structure. So if we want to write it in the short form, so we have to write in this way. He isn't reading a book. They aren't waiting for me. Okay, my dear students, now we will see interrogative form. In interrogative form, the auxiliary verb am, is, are will write in the first place, and then I will add subject plus verb plus ing plus extension. So we'll follow the example. Is he reading a book? Is, so we have transferred verb, auxiliary verb before subject, and we have written, is he reading a book? And there will be question mark, of course, because it's an interrogative sentence. Are they waiting for me? This in this example, the same structure is followed. Okay, my dear students, now I am going to show you the negative interrogative form. The structure will be am or is or are plus subject plus not plus verb plus ing form plus extension. So the example will be like that. Is he not reading the book? Are they not waiting for me? So if we want to write it, these examples in short form, so we have to do it in this way. Isn't he reading the book? Aren't they waiting for me? Okay. So my dear students, I hope you have understood present continuous tense very well. Now I am going to the next lesson, that means lesson 5, present continuous indicative future action. My dear learners, now open your book, English composition, grammar and composition book, page 23. Here lesson 5, present continuous indicating a future action. So I am going to read. A, read the following sentences and look at the underlying verbs. Tell your partner which tense it is. So number 1, I am going to visit my grandma this weekend. What about you? Here he is going. Someone is making a plan to go somewhere to enjoy their weekend. Number 2, do you think our teacher is going to give us a good grade for this assignment? Here is also the same thing. Number 3, who of you are going to work as volunteers? Please raise your hands. Number 4, when is your uncle coming back from his overseas study? Number 5, it is going to be a big problem if you do not pay attention to it now. So all the words, we can see that they are indicating the near future actions. Okay, now I'm going to write down. Now I'm going to show you the present continuous tense indicating a future action. So at first we have to know what is it. When you are informing someone about a plan you have already made or assumed. Okay, this kind of present continuous form indicates an arranged future. So they have used am, is, are, or plus going to indicate a future action. My dear students, look at the board. For example, students, please, everybody, go to the classroom. Your class teacher is going to announce your midterm results in the class. So we can see that they have used is going to, because it's near future. Your teacher is going to announce your midterm results in the class. So sometimes you may confuse am, is, are plus going to future with the same simple future using will. The model will seems best for this situation when you are in process of making a decision about the future. Most often you use or we should use will to talk about the future generally. For example, who will open the door if I am late? Okay, now come to the page 25. Here is some compare these two remarks. Why do you think is the form of the verb rain different in A and B? A, it will rain tomorrow as soon as we get to the park. Number B, according to the weather forecast, it's going to rain tomorrow. Maybe we shouldn't go to the park. So here's a note here. If you make a general prediction about something, you can use will. If you link your prediction to the present in some way, you can use be going to. In sentence B above, the speaker uses be going to because he or she wants to emphasize that the prediction is based on the present weather forecast. So that's all for today, my dear students. You are doing your assignment, that's why I am not giving you your homework. I hope you will practice it in your home and you will learn more and more about this future present tense. So my dear students, stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.